Many famous people in all walks of life passed away in 2018. In another segment on this site, you will find our tributes to those in politics, sports, business, and the media. Now we turn our attention to those who entertained us in song, on television, and at the movies, and some whose contributions were truly out of this world. But let's start in music.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T, find out what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-T, take F-T-C-T.
Aretha Franklin was the queen of soul, best known for songs like Respect and Freeway. Franklin was also a trailblazer for black women in the music industry and beyond. One of the most beloved pop culture figures of the past 50 years, Aretha Franklin was 76. Nancy Wilson was a jazz legend from the 1950s until just the past few years. Known for hits like You Don't Know How Glad I Am and I Can't Make You Love Me, Nancy Wilson was 81.
Does enchantment pour out of every door? No, it's just on the street.
Vic Damone was another classic crooner, best known for You're Breaking My Heart, My Heart Cries for You, and On the Street Where You Live. Vic Damone was 89. Joe Jackson was not in the Jackson 5, but without his pushing, his children may never have been stars. His persistent driving of his kids towards stardom led to fractured relationships within the family. Joe Jackson, the father of Michael, Janet, Randy, Tito, LaToya, Jackie, Jermaine, and Marlon, was 89. Roy Clark was one of the best guitar players of his or any other generation. Best known by some for hosting the long-running show Hee Haw, Roy Clark clearly loved what he did. He died this year at the age of 85.
Too much fun, what's that mean? It's like too much money, no such thing. It's like a girl too pretty, but too much class.
Daryl Singletary was a star in a later generation of country music. Known for songs like Too Much Fun and I Let Her Lie, Singletary was just 46 years old.
You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger?
Younger music fans will remember the Cranberries. And part of what made the group stand out was the distinct voice you just heard of lead singer Dolores O'Riordan. She died in January at the age of 46. In television,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, Schlemiel, Schlemazel, Hasenbemp Incorporated.
Penny Marshall burst onto the scene as Laverne DeFazio on Happy Days, until her brilliant character became the centerpiece of the spinoff Laverne and Shirley. Marshall later became a very successful Hollywood director, leading memorable films like Big and A League of Their Own. Penny Marshall was 75.
You take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and there you have the facts of life. The facts of life.
Edna Garrett kept order in the Drummond residence on Different Strokes, and then for nearly a decade at Eastland Academy and Edna's Edibles on The Facts of Life. Mrs. Garrett was portrayed by the delightful Charlotte Ray. She died this year at the age of 92. Jerry Van Dyke was never as famous as his older brother, but he still made millions of us laugh. Van Dyke starred on the 1960s series My Mother the Car, and then endeared himself to millions more as assistant football coach Luther Van Dam on Coach. Jerry Van Dyke was 86 years old. Night Court was one of the most popular sitcoms of the 1980s, tracking the hijinks in a relaxed New York City courtroom. Harry Anderson led a great ensemble cast as Judge Harold T. Stone. Anderson died of a stroke this year at the age of 65.
Hey, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salads and scrambled eggs. Mercy. And maybe I seem a bit confused.
Another great NBC sitcom was Frasier, and veteran actor John Mahoney was a fan favorite as Martin Crane, the perfect blue-collar contrast to the elitist tendencies of sons Frasier and Niles. Mahoney was 77. Bill Daly entertained America in two memorable roles, first as Roger Healy on I Dream of Jeannie, and later as Howard Borden on The Bob Newhart Show. Bill Daly was 91. David Ogden Stiers was a very versatile talent, rising to stardom on MASH as Major Charles Emerson Winchester III. He later became a well-known voice actor and narrator for many documentaries. David Ogden Stiers was 75. Little House on the Prairie was a heartwarming program. No thanks to Harriet Olson, who created a lot of grief for her husband and the Ingalls family. The overbearing character was the brilliant work of Catherine MacGregor. MacGregor died this year at the age of 93. Stephen Bochco created some of the most successful television dramas of the 80s and 90s, including Hill Street Blues, L.A. Law, and NYPD Blue. Stephen Bochco was 74.
The end of the Civil War was near when quite accidentally a hero who sneezed abruptly seized...
Ken Berry was a fixture on three comedy series, starting off as Captain Wilton Parmenter on F Troop. Berry later had prominent roles on Mayberry RFD and Mama's Family. Ken Berry was 85. Robin Leach was not an actor. He was the host of the extravagant syndicated 80s series Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, which chronicled the jaw-dropping luxury of movie stars and business tycoons, including one who currently lives in the White House. Robin Leach was 76.
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, does whatever a spider can, spins a web any size, catches thieves.
How to describe Stan Lee? Lee was a legend in many forms of entertainment, comic books, television, and most recently, the many Marvel movies hitting the screen. Lee created Spider-Man, the Incredible Hulk, and countless other classic and beloved characters. Also a fan of the comic book fans, Stan Lee was 95 years old. Neil Simon's work ended up on the big screen sometimes, but his real love was Broadway. The writer of The Odd Couple, Barefoot in the Park, and Brighton Beach Memoirs, among so many others, Neil Simon was 91.
He's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we going to do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound just walking.
There was no bigger movie star in the 1970s than Burt Reynolds. The star of classics like Smokey and the Bandit, Cannonball Run, and The Longest Yard, Reynolds later turned to television and starred in the sitcom Evening Shade. Burt Reynolds was 82. Margot Kidder had a lot of roles, but she will always be Lois Lane in the Superman movies starring Christopher Reeve. Margot Kidder died this year at the age of 69. Milos Forman was an acclaimed director. The Czech-born filmmaker collected Best Director Oscars for both One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest and Amadeus. He was also nominated a third time. Milos Forman was 86.
I am Gunnery Sergeant Hartman, your senior drill instructor. From now on, you will speak only when spoken to. And the first and last words out of your filthy sewers will be, sir. Do you maggots understand that?
R. Lee Ermey was a real Marine, but became famous for portraying a fictional one in the Stanley Kubrick classic Full Metal Jacket. Ermey appeared in other films, hosted a program on the History Channel, and did a lot of work with military and veteran organizations. R. Lee Ermey was 74. Alan Bean and John Young were Navy guys, but they are best known for being part of that rare fraternity of men who walked on the moon. Bean was part of the Apollo 12 mission just months after that first moon landing with Apollo 11. He was the fourth man ever to walk on the moon. He also took part in the 1973 Skylab 3 mission. John Young was in space six times. He flew two Gemini missions, including the first one ever to be manned. He later flew solo around the moon as part of Apollo 10, and then landed, walked on, and even drove on the moon as part of Apollo 16. Young later commanded the first space shuttle mission in 1981. Alan Bean was 82. John Young was 87.
At one point, I thought I would see the end of physics as we know it. But now I think the wonder of discovery will continue long after I am gone.
And while our astronauts explore space, some spend their time exploring how it all began. One of the best-known physicists was Stephen Hawking. Known for his bestseller, A Brief History of Time, Hawking overcame decades of debilitating paralysis to pursue his studies. He died in March at age 76. Those are some of the unforgettable figures who left us in 2018. Please be sure to find our segment on those lost in politics, sports, business, and the media on this very same site. I'm Greg Corumbus, reporting for Radio America.